Hi everyone, Dr. Samina Mitha here, naturopathic doctor, and today I'm talking about probiotics. Probiotics are such the rage. Everyone's talking about probiotics and good healthy bacteria, but I'm here to talk really about what probiotics are and why they're important for PCOS. So let's talk about what exactly is going on in the body. Well, your body actually houses billions and billions of bacteria, and it's so important to have a good amount of beneficial bacteria versus bad bacteria. So having a larger population of this good bacteria, which are known as probiotics, it's really important to keep us healthy. And in fact, there's some research in terms of PCOS, and we'll go over that in a little bit. But so what do probiotics actually do? They actually help to maintain our immune system. In fact, there is a part of our immune system that lives in the gut. So making sure that we have a good amount of good bacteria in our digestive system is very important to supporting that immune system. It also helps to protect us against any pathogens. So having the good amount of bacteria in there can help our immune system, and then it can also help to protect us against any foreign bacteria or any issues that are coming in. And we actually have found in the research that it can influence hormones and our metabolic system. So this is our insulin, our glucose, and insulin resistance, especially in PCOS. So let's talk about how probiotics really impact our PCOS. So the research actually says that PCOS women have a lower diversity of bacteria in their gut, even in the vaginal canal as well, where bacteria sits as well. So it's really important to be thinking about probiotics in terms of diet, but also supplementation when it comes to PCOS. The fact that it also impacts our immune system is really important. So, it can help to reduce inflammation in terms of that sense. What they found in the research is that there's a specific bacteria known as bacteroides, and it was actually found in the stool of women with PCOS. So this bacteria was actually shown to promote insulin resistance, hormonal imbalances, and inflammation in women with PCOS. So the more we're able to populate the gut with good bacteria, the better it will be if there is, bacteria in there that is promoting things like insulin resistance and hormonal imbalances. So what do probiotics do for PCOS women? It actually has been shown in the research to improve insulin resistance, improve cholesterol. So we know a lot of women with PCOS have issues with their cholesterol. I often see in my patients that their triglycerides are high, their LDL, which is bad cholesterol, can be high as well. Working on the insulin resistance piece can actually improve our triglycerides. Using the probiotics for that can be important. So again, probiotics can reduce inflammation, which is something we commonly see with PCOS women. Lots of inflammatory symptoms like acne, bloating, pain. So really important here, a function of what probiotics do to reduce inflammation can help here. And last but not least, which is really interesting, the research actually shows too that it can reduce testosterone, which is really important, especially in women with PCOS, because oftentimes that's the pinnacle issue in terms of the symptoms that we're experiencing. So hirsutism, so excessive hair growth on the body, acne, cystic acne, especially in the jawline, chest, back. And when I say cystic acne, those are like those large lesions that kind of hurt or underneath the skin, very bumpy. And then also, so the hirsutism, the acne and hair loss, very prominent in PCOS women, especially in this top area, the crown area here. We're seeing lots of hair fall, especially greater than 100 strands a day. Oftentimes the scalp can be oily too. So using probiotics there, we can also help with reducing testosterone and hopefully some of these symptoms that come along with high testosterone in women with PCOS. So how do you get probiotics in your diet? There's actually some probiotic rich foods that can really help. Things like kombucha, this is a fermented tea, and also things like kimchi, sauerkraut, miso, fermented vegetables, maybe something like pickles, for example. These are areas where you can get probiotics in. I didn't mention yogurt, especially because women with PCOS, sometimes dairy products can cause issues, especially with insulin resistance. And also a lot of women with PCOS have dairy sensitivity. So, you know, you can use yogurt, maybe coconut yogurt, if it's for the probiotic benefits, if it has some additional probiotics in there. So in terms of supplementation, I always get asked, like, what's the best probiotic I should be taking? Well, it really depends on the person, but using like a multi-strain probiotic between like 11 to 20 billion, that will really help the small intestine section of the whole digestive system, where the immune system actually lives. So using a probiotic there can be really helpful. Now, it really depends on the person. So talking to your healthcare professional about what probiotic is good for you would be the best course of action. If you have any questions about probiotics, please let me know. Drop a comment below and I'll do my best to get back to you. Take care, guys. Have a good day.